Hello friends, in this session we are going to discuss about backup in Oracle Data Guard environment. So first thing is that using rmn to backup and restore files in the Data Guard configuration. So here rmn can be used to backup and recover the database in the Data Guard configuration. So here you can use the rmn in the Data Guard configuration to perform the backup activity and for the recovery operation. So standby database backups are usable on the primary database. So see here, if you have taken the backup on the standby database and that backup you want to use on the primary database for the restoration purpose, you can also use. Backups of logical standby database are not usable at the primary database. So if you have configured the logical standby database and you are taking the backup on logical standby database, that backup you cannot use on the primary database for the restoration purpose. The recovery catalog requires when using the rmn in the Data Guard configuration for the physical standby database. So here Oracle give you the best practice that always use the recovery catalog whenever you are using the Oracle Data Guard configuration. Rmn and the Data Guard best practice is that performs the backup at primary and the standby database. Fine, to reduce the mean time to recovery. So Oracle is always recommending that always take the backup on primary as well as on the standby database to reduce the mean time to recovery. And take the daily incremental backups. Next, offloading the backup to the physical standby. So backups of data file and the archive log files are fully interchangeable. Means primary backups you can use on the standby for the restoration. Backup you have taken on the standby that you can use on the primary for the restoration purpose. Control file backups are not interchangeable, fine. So control file backups are not interchangeable, fine. If you have taken the backup on the standby, control file backup if you have taken on the standby, so that backup you cannot use for the restoration purpose on the primary, that is for the control file. Primary and the standby database must use the same recovery catalog. So if you are configuring the recovery catalog, then always use the same recovery catalog whenever you are taking the backup operation on the primary and the standby databases. It is not necessary to register the standby database. So if you have configured the recovery catalog, then on that time it is not necessary to you to register the recovery catalog, standby database to the recovery catalog. Restrictions and the uses. So you must backup the physical standby database. You must not connect to the recovery catalog when backing up, must be connected to the recovery catalog whenever you are performing the backup, and you must connect to the physical standby database within the target keyword. Fine. So this is the restriction, the users not that you need to take into mind whenever you are performing the backup operation. Next, rmn recovery catalog in the DG. So using the rmn recovery catalog in the Data Guard configuration. So use the rmn recovery catalog permits backup to taken onto one database server and it can be restored to the another database server. See, if you are using the recovery catalog and on the primary if you are taking the backup and you have connected to the recovery catalog, so that all the backup information stores were in the recovery catalog. So for the standby database, if you want to restore it from the same recovery catalog, you can just restore your database because all the backup information is available in the recovery catalog. Rmn use the recovery catalog metadata to behave transparency across the different physical databases in the Data Guard configuration. Configure the separate server for the recovery catalog. Here the very important thing, always use the separate server for the recovery catalog, because in case of disaster of any site in the Data Guard configuration does not affect the ability of the recovery catalog for the latest backup. So in case something goes wrong in your primary site or the standby site, fine, and you have configured the recovery catalog on the separate machine, so that is not going to be affect of your backups information. Next, rmn configuration parameter. See, this few of the parameters you need to set up on the primary database and few of the rmn persistent configuration parameter you need to set up on the standby database. So here, which parameter? First of all, just set up the backup retention policy on the primary database. So configure retention policy to recovery window of few days, 7 days or 8 days or 10 days. And also configure the control file auto backup on. And very important thing, that specify the deletion of the archive redo log files. So here you can just configure in the two way. One is a configure archive logs deletion policy to ship to all standby. So this is the first. Like once your archive log ship to the standby, after that you can just delete it from the primary. And the second one, configure archive log deletion policy to apply on all standby. What does it mean? Once the all the archive even transfer ship to the standby and after applying the primary archive logs can be deleted. So this is the very important thing that you need to set up whenever you are using the data guard configuration. Next, physical standby database. Fine. So what are the parameters you require set up that is on the physical standby database? So here configure the control file auto backup on. Second thing, you can just keep the backing up the data file which are already exist with the valid backup with the same checkpoint. So here you can also configure backup optimization on. And the third thing, that is the when the archive logs that can be deleted. So here the very important, configure archive log deletion policy to backup one time to the device type disk. So once the backup is taken at least one time, after that the archive log files can be deleted. So next is block change tracking in the data guard environment. So enable the block change tracking on the physical standby database for the faster incremental backup. So data file blocks that are affected by each database update are tracked into the block change tracking file. So whatever the data blocks are there in the data file, they are affected, so their changes are recorded into the block change tracking file. The block change tracking file is a binary file used by the RMN to record the changes block to improve the incremental backup performance. So whatever the blocks are changed, that is going to be taken into the backup. So here, creating the faster incremental backup. So here block change tracking optimizes the incremental backup, tracks the block that have changed since the last backup. So this is the very important thing, like enable the block change tracking. Oracle database has integrated the change tracking, that is the change tracking file is used. Fine. Change blocks are tracked as a redo is generated, and also the database backups automatically use the change block list. Fine. So once you enable the block change tracking, after that automatically Oracle records the all the blocks, fine, change block into the one binary files, and RMN use that binary files to take the next incremental backup. So let's see practically backup operation in the Oracle data guard environment. So you can take the backup on primary database as well as you can take the backup on the standby database. So backups are interchangeable. So if you have taken the backup on the standby, that can be used on primary. Primary backup can be used on the standby. So here, first of all, let me just connect it to the through the PuTTY. So here, first of all, I'm just connecting to the primary database, and here I'm just connecting to the RMN target. First of all, let me just connect to the SQL plus and check database is up and running or not. So first select name, fine, primary read write mode, and also the your standby, also check the recovery, it's going on or not. This is the standby database. And is a mounted, and also just perform the ultra system switch log file archive log list, just verify all these things 9 and 7, and this is fine. Again, is 10. Fine. So all the archivings are you are receiving. Also check the all the background processes are fine or not. So what you can do, you can just see the things with the your data guard health check. So here I am just executing this SQL statement whether the all the background processes are fine or not. LNS should be there, and the RFS and the MRP should be there on the standby. So here LNS is there. On the standby, you have a RFS and the MRP is there. Fine. So everything is fine. Now just move to the your backup operation. So I'm just connecting to the RMN. I am not configuring the recovery catalog. So directly I'm just connecting to the RMN target and just performing the backup operation. So here, primary connected to the target primary database. So what you can do, backup database plus archive log. So this is going to be
backup is going on the your primary database. The same you are doing in the single instance, fine. And normally in the data guard, you need to use the same thing. No differences. Backup database plus archive log. So this process will take some time. So your backup is completed on your primary database. The same backup you can also take on the your standby database. So here I am just connecting the RMAN. Sorry, let me exit it. So it is in the mounted mode. Recovery is going on. So backup database plus archive log. So this process will also take some time. Fine, so this is your backup is completed. So now you have taken the one backup on the primary, one backup on the standby. So this both the backups are interchangeable. Like if you require the restoration operation on primary, you can use the standby backup. If you require the restoration operation on the standby, you can use the primary database backup. Fine, so control file is only not going to be interchangeable. Fine, so for that you need to take the backup of separate control file, that is for the standby. So next is your RMAN persistent configuration settings. Fine, so if you are using the data guard environment, you can just do the like configure the few persistent settings, like configure the retention policy of recovery window for the specific number of days, like 8 days or 10 days or the specific days. So here we can just see show all command. So here we have redundancy policy, redundancy that is equal to 1. So that you can just change it to the recovery window of the few days. Like if you require, you can change it. Otherwise, you can just keep it. So that depends upon the your business requirement, whether you goes with the redundancy or whether you go with the recovery window. Next, you can just enable the auto backup. So if the auto backup is off, you can enable it. So here configure control file auto backup on. Fine, so this is going to be on the your auto backup. Fine, so this is I am doing on the primary. The next thing is that specify the deletion of archive redo log files. So when to delete the archive redo log files in the data guard configuration on the primary database. So here you configure the archive log deletion policy to ship all standby database. Once the all the archive logs are shipped to the standby database, after that you can just delete the archive log. So this is the after that is going to be obsolete and it is going to be deleted. So here you can just configure this thing. Once it is transferred to the ship to the your standby database, so here at this moment you can see your configuring archive log deletion policy to none. So that we are going to change it at this moment. So here I am just changing it, configure archive log deletion policy to shift to all standby. Fine, so this is going to be changed, show all. So this is configure archive log deletion policy to shift to all standby. Once it is shipped all to standby, after that it is going to be deleted. You can just able to delete. Fine, otherwise you can also see the second thing, that is the one it is going to be deleted. Once it is shipped and applied, after that is able to delete from the primary. So this also you can just change it if it is required. Next is a setting the RMAN persistent configuration parameter on physical standby database. So here on the physical standby, what are the things you require? One, you can just enable it, that is the control file auto backup on. So here you can just enable the control file backup. Let me just come to the standby. So this is the standby, show all, and here configure control file auto backup on. Fine, so this is the you have on the control file auto backup. So this is changed now. Okay, next thing is that the deletion policy. So also you can just enabling the backup optimization off, that is also you can just enable, configure fine, so show all command. So here backup optimization on, and this is the auto backup is also on. Next thing is that specifying the when the archive to be deleted from the standby. So once the backup is taken of the archive log at least one time, after that you can just able to delete. So this is the policies you can just define on the primary as well as on the standby database. So here what I am doing, I am just changing this policy, that is at this moment is a none, but after that once it is backup is taken, after it is able to delete. So configure archive log deletion policy to back up one times to device type disk, right, on the standby. So this is also going to be changed. You can just check. So once the all the archive logs are backup one time, after that it is going to be deleted. Okay, it is able to delete. Fine, so these are the changes you can just perform on the primary and the standby configuration, persistent configuration settings, and also the backup you can take as well as primary as well as standby. Both are interchangeable in the data guard environment. Rest of the things regarding to the backups will remain as it is. Next is enabling the block change tracking. So this is basically used for the faster incremental backup. So how can you enable? See here, once you enable on the primary, you need to also enable onto the standby. So if you want to enable it, how can you enable? So here we have a SQL command, alt database enable block change tracking using the file. So I am just directly creating under the user 1 app oracle ora data under the primary and a block change tracking, okay, blk underscore change dot dbf file. So this is the file, this is the command which is going to enabling the your block change tracking on the primary database. So here, see, I am executing this command directly on the primary, but this is not going to be enabled on the standby. So if you want to perform this enabling the block change tracking on the standby, you need to do it manually. Fine, it is not going to be applied to the your standby. So here I am just enabling the block change tracking. Database is altered. Once you come to this CD Oracle base CD Ora data CD primary, you can see the one block change tracking file is created. Fine, so once this file is created, if any block change tracking logs are there, that is going to be, you can see select star from v dollar block change tracking. Fine, so this is the, you can just see it is enabled, and this is the DBF. And this is the bytes it's consuming. Fine, but the same time, if you are executing this query on the standby, let me just connect to the standby. So I'm just exit it, SQL plus. Fine, so here, if you are block change tracking, it is disabled. So if you want to enable the block change tracking on the standby, the same thing you need to do on the standby database. So here what you can do, you can just use the same path, the same file name, only the things you need to change, that is from primary to standby. So here I am just changing this thing, that is here you are just changing to the standby, and after that you can just check whether the block change tracking is enabled on the standby or not. So here I am just executing this command on the standby. This is also going to be enabled. And here, if I am executing this command again, this is show us this is enabled now on the standby also. So in this way, you can just enable the block change tracking for the faster incremental backup as primary as well as on the standby. So in this session, we have discussed about the backups in Oracle Data Guard environment, how to take backup on the primary and the standby database, how to change the persistent configuration settings parameters, and also how to enable the block change tracking in the primary and the standby database. Thank you.